of the week, daughter of the week, after the devotion. I need my self-esteem right where it needs to be. Shout out to my baby Kayla. She just walked in. All right, amen. Y'all look good. All right, so we're going to talk about, let me introduce myself first. She read the bio, and I do. I teach teenagers all the things that they think they know so that they can go become productive citizens and leave your house and not return. Look at your neighbor and say, I'll leave her mother, her number. Early intervention coach. I'm a master life coach. I also help parents and teens communicate so that they can bring love, joy, and harmony back to their homes. Because you know that leaves in that teenage year, right around 13. That love, joy, and harmony leaves. So look at your neighbor again and say, I need her number. But because you all are well past your teens, and by well, I mean 20, 25, look like the oldest person here might be 30. All right, 32. 25, I had you for 25. But we're going to talk about what it means to be to the God power. Now, I'm going to say this. I have what I call a blinking ministry. Now, if you don't know what that means, a blinking ministry is when you can't really testify too loud. Can I say something about sex, but your mama's sitting next to you? So you can't really, so you just get hit with it, okay? Can't really say nothing about your ex because his current is here too. Just clean. We're going to keep the fights down today, okay? Can't say too much about your current because his ex is going, Can't really say nothing. So go ahead and blink with me if that's your issue. So before I was all the things that my bio say. Before I was a godly woman, I was a regular woman with regular women issues. And by that, I just mean that I went through the ups and downs. I work with teenagers, but I can speak to the heart of women. One, because I am one. Anybody disagree? But I know what it's like to be cheated on. I know what it's like to be lied to. I know what it's like to have a friend dating your ex. I know that struggle that we as women go through. I know what it's like to be up all night waiting on a dude to come home, and you worried, you mad, you crying, you worried, you crying, you concerned again, and then you want to have a waiting exhale party. Yeah. Y'all know what the waiting exhale party is? Your man cheating, yeah. My man cheating. Your man lying, my man lying. Let's blow up their cars. We're blinking. So I know what it's like. I know what it's like, if I could just get real. I know what it's like to love a dude, want a dude, to be with a dude you don't want to be bothered with, but because you need somebody with you in your arms, mm-hmm. You deal with really bad sex, only to end the night in the bathroom taking care of yourself so that it's not a total loss.
We're blinking.
It's okay to blink.
We're blinking.
See, everybody looking forward, so they don't see you blinking. But I know what it's like. I know the struggle. I know what it's like to have too much month at the end of the money. I know what it's like to have your self-esteem shot to hell over a dude. I know what that's like. I know what it's like to be broke and broken. To be molested and have to pull yourself out of promiscuity years later, not even understanding why you're in it. Right. Mm-hmm. Y'all blinking?
We're blinking.
Right. If I ain't hit you yet, I will before the end of the
night. Right.
Yes. But I know what it's like to be out of your mind and have to dress it up. Mm-hmm. Nobody understanding why you out of your mind because you got degrees. You got a good husband. Mm-hmm. And nobody understanding why you're out of your mind. So you dress it up and you walk around. Hey, y'all! You the funniest one. Because you don't want nobody to know that inside. That stuff, right? I'm going to talk about the stuff in a minute. But when I came into the power of God, those things that I struggled with, all that stuff, that the list I just mentioned, became the very building blocks for the very purpose that God had put in me. Now, here's our problem as women. We take those struggles And then we hear somebody talking about that struggle. And we go, keep my name out your mouth. Hmm. Y'all talking
right
about
me.
Because we haven't gotten to a point where we can take and understand that it's not that they're telling our business. When you own your story, they're telling your testimony.
Right.
We get stuck. She telling my business. She always got something to say. Own your stuff. Mm-hmm. And when we come to the power of realizing who we are, when I say to the God part, y'all know in math when you have 8 to the third power, so it's 8 times 8 times 8.
Right.
So you have that 1 8 can become 64, and then whatever times that 8 is, right? That times 8. I'm a mathematician. I'm a coach.
We're blinking.
And so when we get to a point where we realize that we can go from being who we are, Kiana, by myself, to Kiana in the God power,
right,
then my power does not get limited by just me. Me to the God power means that I can really speak into existence the very things that I want to manifest in my life. Has anybody been able to do that yet? Because see, we get stuck in our power. And we forget that, especially as women, our power alone, the power that God has entrusted us with by itself, is so powerful that the very people, we call God Yahweh, El Shaddai, give me some other name. What we call them?
Jehovah Nisi.
Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nisi. And then we give birth to people who call him mommy.
Mm-hmm.
That's power. Did y'all get that? They call God mommy because they don't understand who he is for themselves. And so we become the very representation. And I don't care how great daddy is, they don't call him mommy.
Right.
And so when we come to the realization that me, myself, to my power, make bad decisions on top of bad decisions, even if I have good influences, if I do it outside of God, it doesn't work. And it may work for a little bit. Like, how many of us have, we worked it to a certain point and then everything went crazy and we was just like, what the hell? Are you kidding me? And so, getting to the God power, for me, that process took place in prayer, in life-altering positions. And so, I really, 15 years in church, because I didn't grow up necessarily in church by the standard. Like, I grew up Catholic, but you know, it was the school system that we were really trying to get, not necessarily the religion. And so when I finally came and made my own decision to come to Christ at 19, it took me 15 years to really understand who he was. When you are a baby, and I can say this baby here, when she's hungry, she probably cries. Am I right? And she fall out, and she keep crying, and she do it every time, because that's what babies do. Right. But now at 2, if she can't say, I'm hungry, then we have her evaluated. Am I right? So we've been in church 2 years, and we still throwing the same tantrums.
Hmm.
Now, at 14, I expect her to be able to go and cook her something to eat. But if she's still throwing the tantrum at 14, I'm going to have her and the parents evaluate. You understand what I'm saying? Some of us are relationship in church, and we stay, and we still throwing the same tantrum. Because with maturity comes time. Or I should say, with time comes maturity. And so I learned how to pray. Let me tell y'all about this prayer. I never had to pray the Lord, my baby is sick, and if she don't make it, I ain't gonna make it prayer. So if you know that prayer, I pray that everything worked out. But I do know the Lord, if you just make my period come.
We're blinking.
Lord, this one last time. So the doctor said something about taking an STD test, Lord.
Right.
I don't want to take that test. I know that prayer. Y'all gonna act like I'm the only one. Somebody better believe
it.
Y'all
right
here. Y'all got this toothpick holding y'all eyes. Somebody better believe it. Okay. I ain't gonna do this. I do have my
on my girdle, so I'm just uncomfortable.
My emotional week, y'all good for my self-esteem right now. And so, the prayer that I learned in the last 2 years as I became a mother was different, right? Mm-hmm. Because remember I said, I know what it's like to have a man say all these things. I know what it's like to have a man tear you down. I know what it's like to be told if you have an abortion, we can get back together. Oh, we broke up. Okay. So I know what that's like. And so I had to learn to do my prayers different. I had to learn that everything ain't about me in prayer. Sometimes I got to pray, Lord, cover him and his hurt. Cover him and his hurt and the hers that she don't even know about. Cover him, cover my baby, Lord. Because I can't control what's going on in his household. But I need them to know, Lord, that, you know, if it goes south with my kid in there, it goes, so I can't get here fast enough, Lord. I need that prayer, Lord. That's the prayer I was doing. My cousin said, you can't control what's in his house. So you got to plead the blood and keep on moving. But I could not do that when I wasn't in a place with God. And so I had to get to a place where it was me to the God power so that I could be who he had called me to be and not be sitting in jail trying to have a prison ministry. Yeah. Okay, all right. It's okay to cry. We ain't got to blink on everything. Sometimes you can go on and yell out. I'm okay with that. The blinking ministry is just an alternative, okay? And so sometimes, and I'm going to be honest because I can go there, even to the power of God. Sometimes,
mm-hmm.
my Christian walk interferes with my thug nature. Lord, let him see the hamper, put the clothes inside the hamper instead of on the top of the hamper. Some of y'all praying that prayer. My prayer couldn't be that. My prayer couldn't be that part. I had to be the praying woman and learn who I was to the God power, the studying woman, because those are the people who know who they are to the God power. They are the infinity power. And we walk around going, God, she bragging. No, she know how to good market. She know how to market well. She's doing her part. She thinks that she all that with her degrees. No, you don't know that background. Right. Some of them fought through it. Yes. It took 8 years. Yes. But you got a girl.
Hey. Woo!
So, because we've been in church, playing church, we walk around with our stuff. We got good shoes. We got purses. We got keys to our house, keys to a car that's paid off, a good car this year, right? We got designer jackets on. We got designer eyewear on. We got business cards that show we the bomb. And so we walk around with all this stuff that validates who we are, and we have none of the God stuff that says who we're supposed to be. So we walk around with stuff, and we have no stuff, the character, the integrity, the ability to tell a married man no. Oh, y'all ain't gonna go. Okay. We miss the good stuff, the stuff that we're supposed to have. But when we are to the God power, we don't need that stuff. You can have $1 million in the bank and still drive your 2001 Toyota Camry because your Lexus don't make you. And when we get to the power of God, and we understand that it's a limited power because it's not based on our stuff, but it is based on the joy of the stuff that he's given us, we go to the next level.
Yeah.
Now, again, when we play in church, our power is limited because we are the designer chick instead of the woman who has a bank account. Y'all ain't got me. We go from being the chick that spends our money all the ways we want to being the woman who has a college fund for those kids that we have, who got life insurance. Shoot, car insurance. Yes. Right. See, when we play in church, we still the ride or die chick. When we come into the power of God, we done, well, we gotta die everywhere we go. People don't miss me if I'm not here. I have time to be the ride or die chick when I come into the power of God. You understand what I'm saying? I'm not the, see, because we can be in church and still the, let me show you how I twerk chick. Yes.
Come on now.
But when we come to the power of God, when we get you to the power of God, then it's the, let me show you I'm more than my cooter chick. I'm way more than that. I got stuff to talk about. I got businesses inside of me. I elevate your game. I'm the prize. I don't have to chase you because I'm doing me. And I don't mind being second in your life because I'm first in mine. Somebody talk to me. Ago, and he's saying Shaniqua again, and I just don't know what to do. Girl, don't leave Larry. Larry got a good job. Benefits, your kids ain't gonna have medical. You don't wanna leave him. And then we take all this bad information and we go, God, because you know we still praying, we in the church. I know you a lawyer in the courtroom, a mother to the motherless, a doctor in the sick bed, and I need you to be a lawyer in the courtroom on September 3rd at 3 o'clock. Because I done bust out some windows. And you know, anything over $100 is a felony. Don't ask me how I know. Save Larry, because I ain't letting Larry go. I need you to, God, just follow the list, his number. There you go. But when we get to the God power, he allows us to be better people. He teaches us to be better people. So in relationship to our spouse, to being a woman to the God power sometimes means that I don't hide shoes in my car. I said, I don't hide shoes in my car. It means I stick to the budget because I know it's disrespecting the head of my household when I don't. I'm just going to let y'all be quiet. It means I get my children up early so we don't start the day with me rushing them and cussing them out. I had to learn that. You know what? I'm going to get up 3 hours early instead of two, because two, I can go, okay, iron, shower, get dressed, do my hair, make it. I can do all of that in two, but I need to be able to do it if she don't feel like getting up this morning. Spiritually, it means I don't throw a fit every time something doesn't go my way, because I really do believe that all things work together. Yes. And so if I'm called forward to his purpose, if I'm called to do what God has called me to do, then I don't have can throw a fit when it don't look like things ain't right. Me to the God power means that I stick to the financial plan. It means that I don't just walk around going, this is just who I am. To justify this sourpuss attitude that I've been walking around with for the last 30 years. So when we get to a point where we understand that it is not us to the power of me, but it should be us to the power of God that elevates us to the next level, we will see a move of God in the church. We will see a move of God in our teenagers, in our youth, in our husbands. There is nothing, I'm telling you, can I tell you something as I wrap this up? Men don't argue with you when you're naked.
Come on, y'all, say that.
Say that. So if you blew the budget,
yes,
it's okay to tell your husband while in lingerie that you blew the budget. Now that's not manipulation, that's godly wisdom. She who is wise. You want to stop? You want to stop the fact. And so we have to do things differently. We have to show up differently. Now I gave y'all some real basics, but you know for your own life what it is. You know individually if you need to develop yourself on a daily basis. You know if you need to stop spending. Now people tell us, you know, if you just stop going to Starbucks every day that you, no, that's not how you build your wealth. Now, but stop going to Starbucks, okay? But as we move forward, and as you listen to the other speakers today, just remember that you have a power inside of you that shuts down anything that tries to manifest itself in the spirit realm and come to the physical. You have that power inside of you already. And when you move and understand that your prayer, that your study life is what gets you to the God power, you will see the move not only in the church, not only in your family, but in you. God bless you.